Hello everyone. I work in a geography laboratory for the National French Center for Scientific Research. And a few years ago, we start to replace all our tools to something with R. And one step that was missing was the cartography, the mapping tools to create exactly the same maps that we created with a GIS tool or designing tool. So we create this package cartography to produce publication-ready thematic maps. The idea was to use directly after R and to put it in publication on website or so. Of course, we didn't start at zero, and we used all the core packages for spatial analysis and spatial representation. And we started with SP and ArcGIS and ArcGIDAL and Raster and so on. And when SF began, we used SF for inputs and internally in the package for computation and display. What are the main features of cartography? These are features to create thematic maps, not to display spatial objects, but to create maps with specific representation. So we have as many functions as map types. So we have choroplet maps, typology, proportional symbols, colorized proportional symbols. And the principle is to have as a first argument the spatial object, SF or SP, and then the name of a variable, and then a lot of parameters, or depending on the function. And we have some classical representation like choroplet and typology and proportional symbols, but we have also some more complex or uncommon maps like isoplets or discontinuities or flows. And I will show you some example next. Along with this representation feature, symbology features, we have also some functions that transform spatial data to other spatial data. That these functions are heavily depends on SF functions. For example, we have one to go from points to lines to represent flows, or we have one that takes regions and that outputs only the borders of the regions, and some other more exotic, like from going from a region to a set of line to look like an undrawn representation. And the other aspect that was very important for us was to have a set of functions to create the legends that are good looking and that respect our way of doing legends. So we worked on specific functions to use all the parameters that we wanted. And of course, all the map layout elements like the north arrow, the scale bar, and a box for the title and so on. And all these functions can go together and you can combine them. Along with the package, we have created a cheat sheet that displays an overview of all the functions. It's not maybe not very useful when you have to create a specific map, but it gives a good overview of almost all you can do with the package. We also created a website with package down, so you can access the documentation inline. And we take some time to create a vignette that gives details on each type of representation that we can build with the package. So we have for each representation a short description of when you should or should not use each of the representation, and then a complete example with the map at the end. Of course, in open source software, in R in general, there is not one way to create something, to do things. So there is other way to create maps with R. And the two most common way are using ggplot2 with ggspatial that provide north arrows and scale bars, etc. Ggplot2 was a bit slow to represent geographical data, but the last updates, I think, changed this, so it's not the problem. But it's a general purpose graphic library, not dedicated to maps. So in our opinion, it was not enough to create custom maps. And the other alternative, TMAP, which is a mapping library with similar functionalities, but that use a different grammar, a la ggplot2, meaning using the plus symbol to addition layers of representation. And the other big difference is that TMAP proposed to create interactive maps, and cartography is not proposing that and will not. So here is a complete example of one map. So the first line, you import a special object with SF function stread. And then the main function here is CoroLayer that takes the special object. We represent one variable, med, which is the median income. And then we have some arguments to describe how we classify the data, in how many cases, which method. We also have a set of color palettes that we created specially for the package. I'm not sure that they are very much useful given the new features of colors in R. And then some arguments about the placement of the legend and so on. Each function of the package is almost done the same way. And then the last chunk here is about the map layout, or where you put the title, the sources, the scale, etc. Now I will show you a list of examples that use cartography and other packages to create some maps with the correct layout, etc. So this one is a map of the population smoothed by road distance. So it's the population of each municipality of France. And we managed to smooth the population according to the road distance between each of them. So to create this map, we use the package OSRM that use a mapping engine that where we can get road distance based upon OpenStreetMap data. Then we use spatial position that computed the gravitational accessibility. And then in cartography, with those data, we classify, we use our custom palettes, and we plot the color palette map and the map layout. This one is another map. It represents the dead and missing migrants in the Mediterranean Sea. So it's a huge database that is a bit heavy to handle, meaning morally. And we represent each of the huge events linked to boat that sink into the water and the number of dead. And to create this map, we firstly use SF to create a base map that is really simplified. There is no Black Sea here, or the Atlantic Ocean is not present. We try to have a very simple base map. And then we simply use the prop symbols layer to plot the proportional symbols, and layout layer to add the title and the authors and the scale, etc. This is a map of the median incomes in municipalities in Martinique. And we use get pencil layer to transform the polygons into these end-drawn lines. And then we use CoroLayer to plot the CoroPlot map. And we also have some function to plot labels and to have non-overlapping labels. So the names of the municipalities are placed with this function. Here is another map. I cheated a bit on this one because there is not a lot of cartography in it, but it's used it for some part. Here we took the some points with population on the Paris area. We use SPATSTAT, thank you for SPATSTAT, to compute kernel density estimation. And then with the Tanaka package, we created this shaded contour lines. Tanaka is the person who created this kind of presentation. It's a representation that gives an impression of levels, of relief. It's really nice. And then we only use legend coro to plot the legend. So you don't have to plot the map and the legend. You can plot them separately. And layout layer to plot the title and so on. This one is not seen very oftenly. It's a map of the GDP per capita. So the green regions are darker with the GDP per capita. And on the borders, we draw a line that is thicker, giving the relative value of the GDP on each side of the border. And this kind of map was not easy to create with GIS tools. Exploiting borders was not very simple, and to do it in a reproducible manner was not possible. So we created the function called getBorders that extract the borders of the of polygons with identifiers of regions on both parts of the region of the border. And then we have a disk layer function that just compute the differences between the borders and plot it in proportional lines along the borders. So you can go to the website of the package. This is the first link. You can go also on the GitHub page if you want to ask questions or ask for features or so on. I'm on Twitter and I have a blog. Thank you.
Any question? Yeah, one here.
Just a curiosity, why have you chosen Martinique for your example?
Okay, I lived there for 5 years. So
you're lucky.
And the other trick is it's an island, so it's easier to not having anything outside. I focus on data on a small and compact space.
Okay, well. Thank you. Merci.
Other question? Maybe I have one. So I tried your OSRM package who compute some distances between cities or whatever. And compared to the Google applications, it's very slow. Do you think that it could be improved or?
Yes, it could be improved. In fact, for this package, if you ask for data on the demo server, I put a timer of 1 second between each of the requests, because it's a demo server and you have to be gentle with the people running it. So if you use your own server, maybe it's faster.
So you import the map, OSM map on your computer. So you import your OSM map on your computer
and after the data. Yeah.
Okay. Other question?
A small one in the macro. No, how do you manage the uncertainties in the statistics you present? For example, if you have on Voronoi on tessellation, statistics, mean, confidence interval, do you use HSV process or not?
Use what?
Brightness, for example, to say you have, how do you manage it?
I don't specifically manage it in the package, but I mean, if you have a set of color that you think is the best to reflect your data, you can use your data, your colors. So we don't address this problem specifically, but there is a way to do it.